What is going on, guys? I'm gonna be showing you our bot. This is the Don't Mess With Me. Let's get right into it. Now right here is the very beginning of all of our work. We were measuring out where our Arduino was gonna go and how long it would really need to be using all of our materials well. Measurements. We were able to create the base of our bot, and this would house most and basically all of the stuff that was going to be inside of our bot. Here you can see us making the actual part and cutting out the different pieces. You can see us measuring out and using our material that Michael brought in, and we were using this to make the second layer, and so that it could be the top part of our build. Now is the main part of the build that actually runs the build and makes it work. This is the Arduino and all the jumper cables connecting to the motherboard. This will help the bot run. This is actually the BattleBot code. This is the motor direction that we figured out. So it says right here, and double slash means that it's not going to read it. And so down here, this is declaring the pin modes as an output on the Arduino. And if we keep going down, this is all really confusing stuff because this is the Bluetooth. And this is what's going to be able to make us so that we can use the PS2 controller to run our tank. And as we keep going down, we got more Bluetooth stuff. And then we get into the void loop. And this is actually the main part, which is saying to the wheels that when pad up is pressed, it will make it go a certain amount and it will repeat. So if you press it, it'll go forward. And then same for left, right, and up, back. And it basically just keeps repeating, and this is how it runs. Right here, you can see us actually getting our bot to work. This was the first time it had ever worked. And we have all of our stuff inside there. We actually got back to school and we couldn't figure out why our bot wasn't moving. So we took it all apart and completely rewired it, and that still didn't work. So we checked our code and all that, and it still wasn't working. So we just had to keep troubleshooting until we figured out that the problem was with the example that we were using to build. And now, the moment you've all been waiting for, it's fight time. Next, we win and go undefeated 2-0, and that puts us into the finals against the Ford. Project went really well in that we won, but we also had a lot of struggles. For example, Michael and I at the first part had a hard time being able to work together, and we actually overcome that a bit, and we were able to actually work together instead of apart. We also had to use our troubleshooting minds, and that was honestly pretty hard to spend a whole class just figuring out what we were doing wrong. And we could have done better with that, but it did end up working out, which is good. On the other hand, we went through the steps of troubleshooting step by step and figured out all the different things. So we started off with looking at our code, checking our wires, then we completely unplugged it and we replugged it back in, and we just kept going through that. Another thing that went well is that we were able to work in two different parts of the build. So I might be cutting out something and Michael might be gluing something, or vice versa. And that actually made us be able to get to a certain point a lot quicker, and then focus more on troubleshooting and getting our thing to work. Throughout all that though, we were able to keep our calm and end up winning the competition. Thank you for watching.